Secretary will continue to read.
Calendar number 939, substituted earlier by member of the Assembly, Cahill. Assembly print number 9040, an act to amend the public authorities law.
Senator Stokowski, an explanation has been requested.
Yes, Madam President. This bill is an act to amend the public authorities law in relation to the energy efficiency and clean energy initiatives of the Power Authority of the State of New York, providing for the repeal of such provisions upon expiration thereof. The purpose of the bill is to enhance the energy efficiency, clean energy, energy service, and green building programs administrated by the Power Authority of the State of New York to reduce energy consumption, mitigate environmental impacts from energy usage consistent with the state's energy and environmental policies. This bill will provide NYPA with the authority to design, develop, construct, implement, provide, and administer energy-related projects, programs, and services for recipients of economic development power, expansion power, replacement power, preservation power, high load factor power, municipal distribution agency power, power for jobs. This bill will also give them the authority to, as deemed feasible, advisable by NYPA's trustees, and NYPA may finance, design, develop, construct, implement, and administer energy-related projects, programs, and services for any public entity or and customers of NYPA's low-power cost programs. NYPA may consult standards and other criteria established or adopted by other organizations, including but not limited to the United States Green Building Council in its LEED program, the Green Building Initiative, Green Globes Rating System, and the American National Standards Institute. NYPA may use note and bond proceeds and other authority funds to finance projects and programs. The programs can be used, it can authorize contracts, energy efficiency, clean energy, energy services, green building programs for up to 35 years duration, provided that the duration of any such contract does not exceed the expected useful life of the facilities or equipment comprising such projects. The bill would build upon significant reductions in the consumption of energy and the contributions to a cleaner environment made possible by NYPA's energy efficiency, clean energy, energy service, sustainable building programs, and make it easier for public entities to implement such services and projects. NYPA has invested more than $1 billion in energy-efficient projects at publicly owned facilities in New York State since 1987. Through direct implementation of projects and low-cost financing, its energy services programs have resulted in more than 1,560 completed projects at 2,640 facilities, producing more than $102 million in annual taxpayer savings. Since the inception of this program, these programs have reduced energy consumption in the state by over 900 gigawatt hours and prevented the emission of approximately 824,987 tons of greenhouse gas emissions. An example of one of these success stories would be NYPA's own building in White Plains, where NYPA replaced its chilled water plant as an energy efficiency measure and implemented other measures that earned the facility LEED existing building gold status. The completed project is saving NYPA 4,704,764 kilowatt hours per year of electricity, accounting to a savings of $338,951 annually. The new equipment has reduced greenhouse gases by 3,034 tons per year and mitigated the CFCs that would otherwise be refrigerated of the old chilled water plant. Many of the public entities served by NYPA can make use of these programs, such as the City of New York, the Office of General Services, the State University in New York. No, I'm trying to give them an explanation. Go ahead.
Senator Mazur, why do you rise?
would Senator Stokowski yield for many questions?
Sure, go ahead.
The first question I have, Senator Stokowski, is did you just say that you were pleased to see that the assets of NYPA would be used to do something in the city of New York?
I said that this is a program that is statewide, Senator Maziarz. Whether you like it or not, the city of New York is part of New York State. Currently, in a program that was developed long before I got here, yeah. Power for Jobs, which everybody raves about upstate, has more money invested in downstate New York than upstate. I think that was done by the Republican Senate. Just a guess, because it's 40 years, in the last 40 years. And New York City gets to make use of this program. All of upstate gets to make use of this program. If I'm not mistaken, SUNY, with the exception of a couple of locations on Long Island, is located throughout upstate New York and will be readily available to make use of this. As a matter of fact, that there's fire companies upstate that are using any of these programs. They also can make use of this program. And all the companies in upstate that are trying to achieve energy savings will be able to apply for these programs and get better energy efficiency and therefore save energy costs and save the state money and save us the size of the footprint and carbon dioxide emissions. So yes, New York City's part of it, but so is all of upstate.
Madam President, through you, would Senator Stokowski continue to yield?
Senator Stokowski, do you
continue to yield?
Yes, Senator Stokowski, you pointed out earlier that the Senate approved the Power for Jobs program. Did the Assembly approve the Power for Jobs program too?
I believe they will be.
No, have they in the past?
In the past, yes, they have in the past, yes.
They have.
Yes.
The Assembly has approved the Power for Jobs program since 1997. You read the first, I think, line 3 through 9 of this bill during your explanation about the entities that are eligible under this program for energy efficiency grants from the Power Authority. And it's a very wide-ranging, very broad, very general criteria that the Power Authority will be able to assist them in. Where, through you, Madam President, if Senator Stokowski can answer, where does the Power Authority make its money? Where is the Power Authority going to get the money to fund all of these things from?
I believe, Senator, that a lot of these will be loans and grants, and they'll achieve a lot of savings from the power that won't be used, as they have achieved in the power in the White Plains Station, their own building in White Plains, and as they continue to get more energy-efficient buildings, less energy will be used by each individual user, and more energy will be available for more companies, hopefully, that will locate in upstate New York and then become energy users at in more of these low-cost power programs.
Madam President, through you.
Are you asking Senator Stokowski to
continue?
No,
actually, I'll speak
you?
On the bill because Senator Stokowski wasn't going to answer my questions. The Power Authority gets its money from two places, Senator. It gets it from the Messina plant in St. Lawrence a little bit, but it gets the boatload of its revenue, which Congressman Brian Higgins, who you're very familiar with, a Democrat from Western New York, continually points out, along with myself, they get the boatload of their revenue from the Niagara plant. So money from Niagara, because they operate 16 plants in the state of New York, and they are so inept that they lose money in 14 out of the 16. They only make money at St. Lawrence and, of course, their cash cow, Niagara. So once again, just like back in February of this year, when $550 million was stolen from the people of Western New York, when the chance to create jobs in Western New York, when the chance to have economic development in Western New York was taken away by this legislature. Once again, the people of Western New York are going to have to use their best asset, that hydropower, to fund these energy efficiency grants in New York City, downstate New York, Long Island, Westchester, and across the state. 22% of the homes in the city of Niagara Falls are abandoned. They're not for sale. They're not in foreclosure. They're abandoned. The U.S. Census Bureau estimates that the largest decline in population of any city in upstate New York will be in the city of Niagara Falls. How can that be when right down the road is the largest hydroelectric plant in the entire northeastern United States? How can that be? There should be jobs, there should be companies, there should be opportunities there. Congressman Higgins sees it. I see it. Why don't the people who represent Western New York in this room see it? The Buffalo News continually reminds them of that. And they continually come here and vote against the interests of those young people in Western New York. Senator Adams and Senator Parker spoke very passionately early about young children and their education in the city of New York. And I feel just as passionately about this issue, as I'm sure you all know. It's unfortunate that we had to have this at 3 o'clock in the morning, a power authority bill. Senator Smith, don't ever put a power authority bill on the calendar at 3 o'clock in the morning. I will vote against this. I will ask my colleagues to vote against this. I will beg my colleagues from Western New York to withdraw their sponsorship of this. This is taking our best asset, and sending it to, they define public authorities, public universities, is the City University of New York, taking our best asset out of Western New York and sending it downstate. When is it going to stop? Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator. Senator Stokowski, why do you rise?
Yes, Madam President, I'd like to speak on the bill.
Senator Stokowski on the bill.
It seems like it's very easy for Senator Mazars to stand here and criticize everything that is done from the power plant that is a federal power plant, I might add. I don't hear him complaining about the power that goes out of state, and maybe he wants to talk to the congressman about opening that up and see how well they do at keeping that power. He talks about the money that was swept in the DLP, but he never talks about the $500 million that was swept while he sat on this side of the aisle over the course of the many budgets when they took money from the Power Authority to balance budgets. That was okay, because then Senator Mazars did it. And I would never use a word like he used in that, but when he did it, it was fine. When a lot of these programs were put in while he was here, that was fine. During the course of his budget comments, he said how they could have used that money to reduce people's rates. Well, that money was there the year before. He was chairman of energy, and nobody's rates went down. He complained about an assessment on electric and other power that unfortunately we couldn't get out. We got the telephone part out. However, during the 30-day amendment period of the budget that he always takes so much credit that he fought, he was chairman of energy. Didn't say a word about that assessment. Could have started the fight then, and maybe we would have been successful in getting that whole piece out of the budget. But he sat quietly while the 30-day amendment period went by. Does the whole state benefit from this program? Yes. Does Niagara County need more help? Absolutely. Does Erie County and the other counties in Western New York need more help? Yes. If we want to look who's in charge of Niagara County, we don't have to look far. We know who runs Niagara County. It's nobody sitting on this side. But if that's how we want to play, that's how we'll play on this. This happens to be a very good program. If you want to kill it, feel free. This bill enables companies that get power to do a better job with their buildings, with the way they use their energy. They will end up saving energy. They will save on the carbon footprint. There will be more energy for other companies. There will be more energy to induce more companies to come to Western New York, hopefully, or other parts of upstate. People will go to work. The Power Authority will make money, not lose money. They're saving money in the examples that are in the bill itself. But I guess we shouldn't mention those parts. We should just beat a dead horse. and say that this is just terrible because it takes an asset of the state and uses it for the whole state. If I'm not mistaken, based on the economy in Western New York, we're not generating all the tax dollars, but we're benefiting from a lot of the programs. And I think a lot of those dollars, even in this bad time in downstate, are coming from downstate, coming up here and paying a lot of the bills. And I'm not defending downstate, but this is one New York. And a bill like this recognizes that this is one New York and that SUNY campuses can benefit, authorities can benefit, businesses that do use all these various programs from the Power Authority can benefit from the ability to make their buildings greener, more efficient, better energy users, definitely better environmentally for everyone around it. But if it's politically expedient to kill this bill, then feel free. And all your colleagues should join you. Kill the bill, George. Great job. Be proud of yourself. I think it's a good bill. I think everybody should vote for it. I think it's a step forward for New York State. Everybody's looking how to green buildings. Part of the ARRA money is for green buildings. This program will help that become more efficient and make those dollars easier for municipalities to use. Hopefully we'll be smart enough not to be petty and to pass this bill and add another good program into the asset of trying to make New York a better place to locate businesses and to keep your business in. Because when they have programs to help your business become more efficient and let you use less power, your expenses go down and your competitiveness goes up. So if that's a bad thing, then vote no. I think it'd be a great vote on your part. And it might be our turn to run around to the newspapers and all the TV stations and say, well, you know, we did this program we were going to do for, yep, unfortunately New York City benefited, but it would have benefited all the companies that are getting power for jobs in upstate New York and helped them become more efficient, able to compete better with the other plants that are in their own company, and maybe even be cheaper than a lot of the plants. Maybe keep the Ford stamping plant in Hamburg, where I represent, and make them more efficient in their power use and make them more competitive with the other four plants across the country and keep those jobs in Western New York. Maybe if we had this program, we might not have the cutbacks that they're having at Chevy. But we'll never know, because if they choose to kill this bill tonight, we'll never find out tonight either if in the future we'll have that ability to make these companies more competitive. Hopefully we'll look past that. We'll do a bill that's good for the state of New York. And we'll do what's right for the people that do business and work and live in the state of New York. And I suggest everybody votes for this bill. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator. Are there any other senators wishing to be heard on the bill? Hearing none, the debate is closed. Secretary, please ring the bell.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, Espada, Krueger, Skelo, Smith, Young.
Senator Maziarz, to explain.
Thank you very much, Madam President. To explain my vote, I think that my colleague has to get his talking points updated. He continues to use, and other representatives continue to use, that tired example of previous sweeps from the Power Authority under Governor Pataki and under Governor Spitzer. And he knows, because I've said it so many times, absolutely there were previous sweeps under the previous governors, Governor Pataki, Governor Spitzer, that I supported, because they were used for the right reason. They were used to pay for energy programs. They were used to pay for a program like Power for Jobs. They were used to fund energy development and research in the general fund budget. I remember being at one of these hearings that Governor Spitzer had downstairs in the Red Room, and he talked about when it came on energy issues, and he talked about a sweep from the Power Authority, and he leaned over to me and he said, we have to be very careful. The discussion was, you know, on whether to take money and use it and put it into the general fund. And he leaned over to me and he said, you know, if we get it into the general fund once, it'll become a piggy bank for Shelley. And we sort of laughed and joked about that. And when we did that this year, by one vote in this body, the ex-governor at the time called me up, and he recalled that conversation, because now it has become a piggy bank. The Niagara Power Project has become a piggy bank. This was the first time this year, that a sweep from the Power Authority was intended for the state's general fund. It came to Albany to pay the bills, and it came directly from Niagara. It was also unprecedented in the amount. Congressman Higgins, I say this all the time, much, I'm sure, to the pain of my colleagues from Western New York. Congressman Higgins, a Democrat, said that this legislature took more out of Western New York in one day than the Power Authority has given us in 50 years. Senator Stokowski mentioned the Chevy plant. I mentioned the Chevy plant many times on the floor during the debate on the budget. The Chevy plant just laid off 274 people, UAW people in Western New York. You know why? You know what we did to them in this year's budget? We raised their utility rates by $1,000 a week. That's what we did to them. We wouldn't have to do that to them if we could keep our power, if we could keep the money that's generated from selling our power in Niagara, and I'm sure the same is true in St. Lawrence, we wouldn't need a stimulus package. We wouldn't need help from the state of New York. Niagara Falls wouldn't be a dying city that it is today, and Western New York would be a vibrant community with people moving in instead of moving out.
Senator Maziarth.
Yes.
How do you vote?
Is my time up?
Apparently.
I vote in the negative. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Maziarth. Senator Thompson.
Yes. Let me thank Senator Stokowski for being the lead sponsor on this bill. I think it's very important that we support this economic development tool. And I would just say that, you know, it's easy to, particularly for people in Western New York, to get caught in the gridlock of Albany. I think that many of my colleagues on the other side of the aisle from Western New York know that the Western New York delegation is used to have a rich tradition of working together in a collegial and bipartisan way so that we could work in the Assembly and the Senate to bring home our resources for Western New York. And I believe that we have gotten on the wrong path, the path of gridlock and destruction, and which will hamper our ability to work collectively across the aisle to deliver for Western New York. Because we in Western New York are always concerned about making sure that we get our fair share. And I would just say to my colleagues, when I was in the minority, I used to work with folks and listen, and sometimes I agree or disagree, but I always understood one thing, is that together we can work collectively to produce for Western New York. And I think that since January, we have been on a very destructive course that will not benefit Western New York. So I would ask that as we move forward over the next year to year and a half, that we be mindful of why we were successful in the past. That's because Democrats and Republicans from Western New York always worked together. We didn't always agree, but one thing we always agreed on was making sure that we sent a united message to deliver for Western New York. And I would say that we need to get back on that path, because that's what the people from Western New York want. Anyone can throw a rock. Anyone can throw a stone.
Senator Thompson.
So I.
How do you vote?
I support this bill, and I also believe that, you know, you can't change the rules because you're in the minority. You know, if it was good to be collegial when you were in the majority, it's good to be collegial when you're in the minority as well. Thank you, and God bless you.
Senator Thompson will be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Those recorded in the negative on calendar number 939 are Senators DeFrancisco, Griffo, Libous, Maziarz, Winner, and Young. Also Senator Little. Also Senator Ranzenhofer. Absent from voting, Senators DeLon, Huntley, McDonald, Montserrat, and Honorado. Ayes 44, nays 8.
The bill is passed.